So, I needed to change my speakers on my Harley because the system that I'd used before were two powered speakers made by Blaupunkt PC series. See the power mechanism on the back of these. Worked off a quarter-inch jack that went into the bottom of my old iPhone. New iPhones don't have a jack. So I decided to go with a Bluetooth Kenwood speaker, Kenwood amplifier, 400 watt, with a set of Polks. Now I tried to use the old speakers because I didn't think there was anything wrong with them, and then when I got the whole system up and running, it turned out that he was blown. So went with a little bit of a higher output. These are about a 50 RMS, and so that should be compatible with the Kenwood amplifier. Then I had to find a place to mount the amp on the Harley. So this is a 2003 Heritage Softail with about 16,000 miles on it. I don't get to ride too much, but as you can see, I do have a windscreen, but I don't have it on right now, and there's no place to mount any speakers. So I had installed these buckets, chrome buckets, for speaker housing. That's where the old Blaupunkts were in there. And since there was no amplifier other than the powered units on the back of the speakers, it was just an easy quarter-inch plug that went to the back of my iPod that mounts here with a RAM mount. Needed to find a place to put the amp. So when I purchased the bike, I had the dealership install a Road King headlight in the cell that is different from the Heritage Softail. Heritage Softail has a flat fork cover, and the headlight itself is mounted externally to that unit. This is an enclosed unit that gives it a little bit more sleeker look. Take off this cover. A little bit of a sleeker look to the front end of the Heritage. So kind of a combine the Road King look and the Heritage look. Now that created a huge space in behind there. I should have taken pictures and video before I put it together, but the Kenwood amp fit in there perfectly. All of the wires I've neatly run into the fork tube and into the speakers, as you can see here. They're coming through here and back into here. So they're all wired up. I can mount my GoPro back on the RAM mount. I have to do this, I need two hands to do this. It goes like that. And I'm ready to rock. So amplifier is hooked. This is the charging line for the iPhone. I'll use that later. The amp itself actually had a had a plug just for the charging wire, which was nice. Kenwood amp also comes with a hand controls that I'll mount onto the clutch cover. I'm waiting to get the RAM mounts for that with a 1-inch ball. So this is going to be mounted over here. That's the controls for the Kenwood amp. The sound is quite impressive. So, as I said, it's on a switched ignition for the amplifier. You'll see the Kenwood controls cycle, connect with the Bluetooth.
Thank God.
crank it up. Restart. Thanks, YouTube.